color really is capable of evoking sensations and evoking memory, evoking happiness or sadness even. When thinking about that on the surface of a map and reflecting these natural places, that's really powerful. When I joined Google Maps, pretty quickly I realized that there was just a lot of complexity on the map, like 700 colors. The process really started with a hypothesis that we were able to reduce this really complex system down to a core set of colors, but also bring this life or energy to the map. It wasn't really even about choosing colors like out of the air. It was about looking at this palette that we use for most design at Google and then looking at the natural landscape and seeing how we could draw those connections. Some of the areas, while we sort of had a notion of what they looked like, surprised us. Previously, the color for the tundra area that is north of Canada was this light gray, which in reality was not actually how it looked in satellite imagery, which is these stone deep grays. Large swaths of desert areas in Africa didn't feel reflective of the places themselves. It really didn't sit right with me in terms of understanding regionally what that desert actually looks like. You need to believe what you're seeing on the map. That's so important, and you need to have the confidence that it's reflecting the world that you're living in. The way that we were shaping how to bring all these colors together were from personal experiences across the team. It came back to that responsibility of, is this reflective of that place? What I spent a lot of time thinking about, like, was where I grew up. Thinking about Michigan and thinking about Northern Michigan specifically, most of my childhood memories are of this pretty specific area. I think about how it felt to be in those spaces. Summertime in the Midwest was you running through grassy yards and going to camp up at the lake and how that space made you feel. Color is a huge part of that experience that you were having at that time. Water was one of the most interesting parts of the map to design. Water is so personal for people. Where you grew up informs a lot about how you perceive color and the emotional layer that you put on it. We actually had to do probably 50 to 100 explorations of how to actually change that color and reflect it back to people in a way that felt right. The thing that we leaned back on was zooming in and looking at color specifically, but then zooming back out to a different altitude of, does this feel like it's cohesively mimicking what you would see in the real world? We set out to reduce the complexity of the map, to really improve known user issues like contrast, making sure that roads were super easy to see, accessibility, but I think that goes hand in hand with reflecting back to our users the world that they live in or capturing that vibrancy in a way that feels meaningful. Color is personal and our environments are personal, and the way that the planet is reflected to them in this tool that they happen to use every day, there's a chance to create a stronger connection for people.